I'm confident that Gary Janetti will not violate our risque word warning that we gave him before. Glad that he is, that you're here. People love your Instagram out of their minds. And you and Brad Gretzky have been together for how long?
18 years.
18 years. So this is the latest posting just from Halloween. He dresses up.
Oh, God, yes.
Wow. Yeah, yeah.
My goodness.
You know, that seemed to be a favorite. I saw a lot.
Yeah.
So this is Brad as Jennifer Lopez. Gary writes, this looks more like A-Rod. How did that play at home?
You know, I've been out on a book tour. I came back, and he was like, I thought he was going to be Demi Moore in Ghost, and I was supposed to be Patrick Swayze, and he had it for me, and I was supposed to get behind him and recreate that photo. And when I got home, he's like, I changed it up. I'm Jennifer Lopez. I'm like, thank God. Like, I have no part in this, right? He was like, you have no part in it. And then it took him however many hours to look like that. You know, I stayed home and handed out candy.
Okay.
You've had a great run as a comedy writer, Will and Grace, Family Guy, a lot of shows that people absolutely love and enjoy.
Yeah.
Was social media like a godsend?
You know, it's not so much that it was a godsend. It was just kind of, I was a fun way to play around with stuff. On Instagram, I was just kind of entertaining myself with the Prince George stuff. So I never expected it to become what it did, you know, but it's been a nice surprise.
How did Prince George, though, become your inspiration, if you will?
You know, it was just 2 years ago, I saw photos.
I don't think he's really holding your book, by the way. Anyway, go ahead.
I know, that's a good one. Alan Bala does my Photoshop for me, and he did that really well. He was going to school for the first day, and he was so expressive. This was 2 years ago, and I thought, I'm going to write a caption for this, for his, you know, for his face, and then nothing. And then a month later, I was like, could I use another photo and do it again? And then I did. And then when Meghan and Harry got engaged, my first thought was, oh, George isn't going to like this. And from there, it kind of, like, people kind of got on board, and it just snowballed.
Wow. And then I don't know if that, dare I say, increase in fame or popularity led to the offer to do this book. Or you tell
me. You can say increase in fame and popularity. Sure. And it did. Right. It actually did. Flatiron Books reached out to me. My editor, James Milia, came over and he was like, would you be interested in writing a book? And I was like, yes, definitely. I had no idea what I would write or what it is to actually write a book. You know, it always seems like such a daunting thing whenever you're in a bookstore. It's like, how does somebody do that? But I said yes, and then I thought, I'm going to have to figure out what I'm going to write. And I just wrote a book of kind of personal essays from my childhood and young adulthood.
All right. Now, one of the log lines say that maybe you complain about the mundane.
You know, about what?
The mundane aspects of certain.
Yeah, it's more that things that still annoy me from my past and, you know, about things that I've kind of remembered and kind of am working through kind of as I go through and kind of reminisce about them.
Now, I would think one thing about being a big shot TV comedy writer, and this is in my head.
Okay.
Is it the greatest lunches of all time?
Lunch is good. If I like the place, I'm happy when it's Jones on 3rd, L.A.
You know,
we love our Jones on 3rd. There are some places I'm less happy with.
All right. And is the whole morning just spent fighting over menus?
That is a part of the day, yes. Yes, I'm not going to lie. Right. Menus, where's lunch? Where's lunch going to be today is the first question.
Yeah, 9 a.m.
So how long will the debate wrestle over that?
It depends. It depends on the show. It depends on the people. But it could go back and forth a little bit. Yeah.
Now, you and Brad are doing something for this new HBO Max. What's that?
Yeah, we're doing a travel reality docu-series.
Okay.
Over the summer, Brad and I went to Italy, and he was filming me and him eating in restaurants and stuff on his Instagram stories. And apparently, it took off. And then we got offered a job from HBO Max. They were like, would you like to go eat? Yeah, to go eat and to travel around the world. Would you like to travel around the world and go eat? And I was like,
wow.
Hell yeah. You know, I will do that, of course. So we're going to start filming that next month.
Wow. Any destinations set out?
I just got back from my book tour, and we're going to start talking about where we're going right now.
All right.
Amazing.
Yeah. Now, I would think that, like, Italy, as an example.
Yeah.
Everything's good.
You'd think. Most everything is good, but sometimes it's like the bigger thing is almost when you've ordered the wrong thing. Mm. Your thing is good, but you see the better thing.
Oh, yeah.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I do have that. Ordering can be I should have had that.
My wife has plate envy beyond belief.
Right. So it's, everything is good, but you want the best.
Yep.
There you go. Your opportunity to meet Gary, you can do it. The book, Do You Mind If I Cancels, out now. Gary, signing copies tonight. Big booking, Barnes & Noble at the Grove.
Barnes & Noble at the Grove.
Come by and meet Gary tonight, as we have met him this morning. Good to have you here.
Thank you
so much for having me, guys.
Thank you.